So these are all today's technology trends. I want all of you to read, keep them in mind, so that we could design better in the next 1.5 hours. I'll read them for you. So from the desktop to mobile, from the whole context of searching for the information to an information reaching you at your will. The next one is from premise to cloud, on-premise to cloud, Internet of Things, from the transactions to the interactions data being more important, trying to crunch data from all of these to make some business sense, and most importantly, data. There is a lot of data in most of the organizations, which is extremely valuable, but I've seen a number of cases wherein people don't know what to do with it, or people don't have the right tools to do whatever they are supposed to be doing. Have you heard of a profession called data scientist? So data scientist is supposed to be the most looked for professions in the world today. Anyway, so our design problem is kind of near the data scientist area. So there is a lot of data available in most of the enterprises. Let's take the case of an airlines. You know, the airlines that our CEO was traveling with had a lot of data about that airlines, about that customer. So I'm talking about one customer, one business. So A airlines and one CEO of a big company traveling with that airlines for last, how many flights he would have taken through that airlines in his lifetime? It'll be a number, right? Few hundred flights he would have taken with the airlines. So look at the amount of data, look at the gold mine they are actually sitting on. They clearly know typically what time my customer flies, typically what time he avoids shorter flights in between, he avoids a particular station. So that data is relatively easier to derive from all the transactional information. I don't know whether all these companies do it, but they better do it. But I'm actually not talking about that data alone. The moment I mash some personal data, like the LinkedIn profile, actually, interestingly, LinkedIn profile gives you a timeline of a person, right? So from the point of me starting my first job to about today, how many number of years, what I've been doing, where I've been staying, what has been my designation, roughly you could predict the kind of income he'll be having, which location, and so on. So interestingly, there is a lot of interesting data about our customers lying in the internet, not owned by us, us as in an enterprise, right? So I am an enterprise like that airlines company or the automobile manufacturing companies or one of the supermarkets here in India, anybody, all these enterprises actually, if they wish to, can access a lot of interactions data of their customers. Agreed? They anyway own a lot of transactional information in their systems. So take a case of a supermarket. A supermarket being visited by the same family, now that I'm just starting to increase that whole word from one user to a family, right? So for example, I'm a family of four, my wife and two kids, my son is 15, my daughter is about 9, they go to a particular school, they have preferences. The moment I walk into a particular superstore, for that matter, buying some gadget for myself, maybe a Fitbit, so that time, if at all, imagine, that store has access to the information about me. What information? My family, my friends. It's very easy to find, actually. So it's not rocket science, right? So if you want to, you can find a lot about myself. My Facebook profile, my LinkedIn profile, and 1,000 more social networking sites. So all these sites.
The simple thing is, even when you go to an electronic store, as simple as if I have bought something from a store called like Roma, right? Like, I bought a refrigerator over there, and about a year later I go back. It's simple for them to set a warranty extension.
Absolutely, as simple as that. They should just come in and say, "Hey, Atul, thanks. I know that your warranty is expiring," and so on. So the again, going back to my the trends of technology, so having that information available at the right point is where probably we are lacking. Do you all agree with me? So the information is very much there. All the transactional information obviously lies in most of their ERP solutions or otherwise, and most of the customer information, the personal information about the customers, are lying on the internet. At this moment, for the next 1.5 hours, forget the ethics part of it. Right now we are just designing, right? Yeah, I know that. So don't talk about that, don't think about that. It's just a design exercise, don't worry. So now let's go into a couple of cases, you know. Let's take a case of hospitals. Let's take a case of a supermarket. Let's take a case of maybe a automobile brand, maybe, I don't know, Mercedes in India, or Maruti in India, one of the most popular brands, right? And so on. So just imagine if Maruti India showroom, inside the showroom, the manager or person who's going to be talking to the customer will have all this at his fingertips. Then he'll be able to serve their customers much better. Agree with me or no? Yes. Make sense? So that's the whole idea. That's the whole idea we are trying to explore today in the exercise. So effectively, which data about the customers is important for my business? The moment you start asking that question yourself, I'm sure you'll be able to form your own opinion. You'll be able to say, hey, okay, let's take a very simple case of maybe a small chaiwala who is serving tea close to a IT park, you know, in an entrance somewhere. He just sells tea, cigarettes, and little snacks. So that particular little vendor, can he make use of data? If at all he has. If at all he has information about any information that you wish to about the customers he has. Any examples? Absolutely. He knows the break times. He knows their preferences. He knows which brand of cigarette this person likes. Especially in India, I remember a friend of mine is a big time paan shokin. So he goes near the paan shop and he just does this, you know. And the paanwala knows that what kind of configuration of the paan, you know, what he loves and stuff like that. So the paan is made to his order and it is served to him without him asking for it. So that's the value of the service. And then he feels so much privileged by the service that he'll go to this paanwala only. That's about it. Anywhere in the world, he'll come there, he'll have his paan and stuff like that. Practicing that. But is it really possible to do it in a larger enterprise? Is it really possible to do it in a Toyota showroom in Bangalore? And stuff like that.
Generally, people, businesses look at the data from their perspective. You know, how many cars I sold. But they don't look at, for example, I'm an Airtel customer, loyal Airtel customer for 16 years.
Unfortunately.
I never got a call from them. I mean, not even once in the 16 years. Proactive call. So, you know, nobody's looking at the data for the customer. They just look from their business perspective. What data
Absolutely.
Makes sense for the
Absolutely. So the whole design exercise that we are going to jumping into is just revolving around this. Which data of my customers? So we are going to enact like we are part of an organization as a group. So for example, your group could take up anything. I'll show you. There is a structured process. So your group could say that, okay, we are taking automobile agency. I don't mind you taking a brand name as well. So you could say that Maruti, because sheer volume. So Maruti showrooms in India is my target, and how could Maruti make use of transactional data, which they already have, and interaction data that they can very easily get. How to serve it on their platter, don't worry at this moment. Okay? So imagine that there is a mechanism that gives you all that data. So how can I make use of that data for my company is the single question I'm going to ask you. Making sense? Okay, let's see how. So having up-to-date information about all the transactions is absolutely necessary. How many of you have experienced a couple of calls from the call center when you make a transaction on your credit card? So when you make a transaction on your credit card, which is anything higher than X amount, they'll give you a call just checking that, have you made that transaction? So I felt so comfortable the first time I received that call. Oh, wow, I'm spending about a lakh of rupees, and now that somebody is calling me at least, you know, and saying that, is that your transaction only? And when I say yes, they'll approve it. So the moment I swipe the card, actually the next second I got the call. Yeah? That's the kind of world we are living in. So that transactional data being appropriately used and putting some business intelligence and taking some actions is now happening. Sorry.
Some of these transaction data can be outdated, right?
That's precisely what I'm saying.
For example, I'm from Eureka Fox to but still they keep calling me when I'm in
Absolutely. So an enterprise can talk about the transactional data that they own. They cannot talk about the transactional, Maruti showroom cannot talk about if somebody has bought a Mercedes in some other. That transactional data will not be available with me, right? So I'm just talking about how to make sense of all the transactional data that I as an enterprise own and legally underlined, fetching all the public data available about the customers, is it possible to mash this data together appropriately? I'll give you an example again. So I'm owning a huge supermarket chain in India, and he's one of my loyal customers for last 7 years. And probably the way I'll mash is, one very simple example. I know his birthday, right? A number of ways to get his birthday. So the moment I have his birthday, I sent out an email saying that on your birthday, here is an offer. There are a number of ways. So that's a very simple example of how to make use of that public information. So I want all of you to brainstorm a little more, jumping into that role and stuff like that, to try and figure out what other data is relevant for my business. I don't mind you taking hospitals. I don't mind you taking any other verticals. So let's really jump into that. So what is the information I am interested in about my customers? I am definitely interested in how many unhappy customers do I have per month. I mean, this is at a business level. Make sense? Whereas, same question. So this is more of a question to the chief marketing officer, maybe. Whereas the person who is physically selling the cars, who is showing you the features of the car inside a showroom, will have the same question slightly differently. Is this customer that talking to me, is he one of my happy or unhappy customers? Making sense? So all these questions have kind of two edges. One at a personal level, one at a kind of business level. So why are these customers unhappy, if at all they are unhappy? Why is this particular customer happy or unhappy? Or why he's happy? I mean, he's here because he's happy about my brand, probably at this moment. But what other brands he loves? So these are the kind of secret questions in my mind when I'm a salesman or when I'm a chief marketing officer. So all these are the secret questions actually in my mind, right? Unless I know the answers, I'll not be able to sell better, obviously. So now we are planning to build a magical tool. Why I'm calling it magical is two reasons. One is keep ethics, legalities out of this room for next 2 hours, okay? That does not mean design something unethical, but that's a different problem to solve, right? So data security, ethics in finding, using somebody's information, keep that aside for a while. And I'm trying to say is open your minds, think of all the social data, all the personal data that is publicly available about my customer singularly or about my customers. So that has two connotations again. When I say Atul Manohar as a customer, the sales person, if at all he knows birth date of my wife for that matter. All the husbands make the mistake of forgetting the birthday once, but the business and getting thrashed throughout the life. Anyway, so effectively if the salesperson really knows the birth dates of my kids and so on, he'll be able to suggest me more, right? Much more intelligent suggestions and recommendations. So me as a person, me as my family, me as my close circle, me as my secondary circle, like friends, influencers, and stuff like that. How many times you have called up a friend saying that, hey, by the way, I'm planning to buy a camera. You have a Canon. What do you think of Canon? How many times you have called? Almost every time, right? So every time you are making a big decision of buying, you call up somebody who has really physically used it and stuff like that. So these calls are actually recorded in the social media quite a few times, right? How many times you have seen all these questions being asked on Facebook? Hundreds of times. So that is public information anyways, right? So now let's go into the exercise. Is it possible to split into, we have five tables. So would you like to join one of these groups? Would you please? Just pull your chairs and come closer to one of the tables. So let's. Right? So what you have here is on a y-axis, you have different domains, right? Different verticals of industries. For example, retail, banking, financials, healthcare, travel and logistics, hospitality, manufacturing, telecommunications, government, media, entertainment, education, and a few more, I'm sure. Satyam, we used to talk about, I don't know, 20 more names. But anyway, the idea is on this graph, on this kind of map, on the y-axis, we have all these vertical industries. And on the x-axis, I am defining scale of the industry. So on the left side, so for example, in this zone, these are very small, tiny businesses. It could be a family business or the chaiwala I talked about, very tiny business. So this section is a small business for that matter. So I could even put cements. So this section is nothing but the largest corporations that we hear of, right? All the listed companies in India, we have got Mahindra Group, Tata Group, Godrej, and huge enterprises, right? Billions of dollars of business. Whereas here it is maybe only national presence, but still big company. This is a small and medium industry, and this is a tiny industry. So roughly, I'm just categorizing all the industries into four sections for the ease of our understanding. So what you're supposed to do in a group is, I'll give you only 3 minutes to finalize a vertical. Any doubts about the verticals? No, right? Take anything interesting. Maybe take gaming, take entertainment, anything you want. So take one vertical and define your company. So say that my company is global or it is only whatever. So I want you to put a dot, for example, here, saying that, okay, this is the category I'm interested in. Making sense? And for the time being, for the next 1 hour, we'll be kind of designing as if we are part of that organization. And all of us, you sitting over there, is the decision-making board, is the CEO, marketing person, and the developer, and the designer, everything. So you own the complete decision power for that company for the next 1 hour. So that's the kind of privilege I'm giving you. So next 3 minutes, please finalize the segment of the industry size-wise. I don't mind this also. This is also very interesting, by the way. The smallest industries are also very interesting. Simply because, what is the difference between these four in terms of our exercise?
Reach.
So it's very easy to get customer information here, isn't it? Whereas it becomes more and more difficult getting information on this side. It's okay. I don't mind you solving any kind of problem. So you select a vertical. You don't need to just select a vertical. You could say that, by the way, travel and logistics, I'll design for one airlines. I don't mind. Maybe Jet. Okay. I'm designing for Jet. And that table, all of you around that table own Jet Airways for 1 hour. Make sense? So please finalize your vertical, please finalize your industry, and try and understand which segment the industry falls into. Please go ahead. Yeah, they'll be meeting. Industry, I want all of you to write down some 10-15 critical points about that industry on a A4 site sheet. So critical things like, number one, what are the products of that company / services? What is the objective of that company? Selling more, or for them it is collecting more taxes, or whatever it is. Objective of the company. Try and write down a couple of critical roles in that company, right? So like the CMO in maybe hotels, in tax department, I don't know, revenue tax. Few bullet points, 10, 15, 20 bullet points on our A4 sheet, writing about the type of business we are into, type of ownership, and who are our customers, how many probable customers, how many existing customers. You could guesswork, it could be a guesswork. I don't want real data anyway. But interestingly, your guesswork will be also more or less similar to the real data, right? That's interesting. So try and guess how many customers will be there, and try and put up one of you act like a chief marketing officer. So please designate a chief marketing officer in your company, in this table. And the chief marketing officer should write down all these numbers saying that, okay, what are my targets in the future? Right now, I've got these many hotels, etc. Right? So the second section, if you are through with the first one, you're not?
Sorry.
Are you through with the first section? Writing about that industry, all the groups?
Yes.
All done?
Yes.
Fabulous. So let's go into the next most interesting part, which is, so please listen to this question. So how can this business, how can Taj Group, put your own name, how can Taj Group make use of information about, how empowered the CMO is, right? So you are all designing for the CMO to start with. Trying to make use of all the information that you have and that you could potentially have, now that we know that interactions data, how to make use of that information to increase sales and revenue. That's the bottom line. In order to do that, you could probably write down a couple of more objectives. So in order to be more relevant, in order to be more revenue-earning company, I need to be more popular and blah, blah, blah. Are you getting my point? So sub-objectives of these two is something you have to write down for your own company. Then it becomes much more clearer how to achieve that. Making sense? The next question is, customer information, imagine that all this information is available. I do not care how. So all the demographic data of your existing customers is ideally there with you, but I have seen most of the companies don't even know how to use it. So how many of my customers are in Pune? How many of my customers are in, and so on, So all that data is kind of there. Demographic information includes age, sex, economic status, location, language I speak, everything. All that put together is called as demographic data. So all the demographic data about the customers, whether it is, now that all data will be scattered across the own systems and outside, I don't care how to get that. So all this data, their social media content and connections, do I know how many friends he has on Facebook, what kind of friends he has, how many of you have Facebook account? Wrong question. So that necessarily